I'm going to take Purvi and Harshit through a home workout. Guys and girls, if you are at home and you don't know what to do and you've never worked out in your life, this is where you can start. Or even if you worked out in your life and you want a routine for yourself, this is where you can start. And this is what we're going to do. We're going to start with a little bit of stretching first. So Harshit, just come in. For stretching, I'm trying to do more dynamic stretching at this point. I'm not doing static holds. I don't know how stiff their bodies are. They've been training with me the last few days, but it's not like they can just, you know, touch the ground in one go. Let them get used to it. Let them get into the motion. Some side twists. So let your ankle go off. You're turning at the hip. Full back. Look as behind as possible. 10 times a side. Then you go up. 10 times a side. Yeah, open it out. Turn your hips more, turn your hips more. Yeah, open it up. Now you go slightly wide on your knees and you touch this. So I know a lot of you guys, I know all of you people keep telling me that Tarang, you look a certain way because you've been training for years, you're genetically gifted. I wasn't like this when I started. It just took me time, it took me years. It's been 10-15 years of being training in one way or the other. Not always bodybuilding, different kind of things. This is how I actually started. This is how all of us started when we were younger. We did these speedy drills, right? Okay, so you're going wide again. If you guys can't do this, this is also too much for you. One, two. 3, 4, keep your legs straight, open out your hips, open out your adductors, open out your hamstring, go 10 aside. So these guys are going for 25, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, your lats are opening out, your hips are opening out, your body is opening out. Once you guys are done with 25, hands up in front of you. Yeah, look up. Hands here. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So you're using your elbows, taking your body, pushing your body in front, using your elbows, pushing your body back and wide. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Once you've aced that, you go for 1, 2, 3, and then you go 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Give this 10 times. 20 jumps in the spot. So you, whenever you're jumping, whenever you're doing any movement, be it any exercise, any running, any sprinting, you always want to try and land as soft as possible. That means you don't want to land like this, you want to land soft, okay? So you guys are going to jump 50 times, yeah, one leg then the other. Slowly, land, yeah, come on, faster. See how softly Harshit started landing, look at his knees. Look at the motion of his legs. It's more athletic. Purvi, softer. Take your knees up higher. Look at Harshit. Face Harshit. Look at his knees. Yeah. Yeah, better. Go faster. Okay. Now, one leg in front, one behind. Soft. Listen to the sound. Harshit, come a little bit in front. Now, flatten out your feet once. So show how, what is the bad form for this? You see that? That's what you don't want to do. Land soft, yeah. Keep going, Purvi. Purvi, come a little bit in front. Next to Harshit. Yep. Superb. Now do it sideways, cross. You're going cross. Yep. Soft, soft. Don't go wide. Stay in that same position. Yeah. Nice. So guys, these guys, these people are not getting trained. They're not used to training. This is something new and it's very easy, very efficient. It's not like too much effort. I'm not making them touch a barbell, neither will I make them touch a barbell. Maybe I'll make him squat at some point because he's got a good range of motion, good mobility. I can see his movement is very fluid. But at this point, I just want them to improve their overall health and well-being. So now we're going to do 50 jumping jacks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, keep going, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, good. Your parents can start doing this, your relatives can start doing this. Look at her, come on. You gotta go for 50. Purvi doesn't usually work out like this. She does some kind of exercise, some kind of training. I'm also looking into their nutrition right now, so I'm going to help them eat better. My next video is going to be primarily about nutrition. Keep going, Purvi. No stopping. My next video is going to be primarily about nutrition and how you should be eating. Not only with regards to the coronavirus and what's happening in our country, but generally some nutrition aspects that you have forgotten and you possibly know. Just some things that you can correct which will make you way healthier. Keep walking. Don't ever like stop. I don't want you to sit down. So your heart rate is up right now. You know, I want to keep that heart rate flowing. I'm not trying to push out. So yesterday I made them do a few exercises which involved a lot of, it was a lot of muscle strain. They were like rep maxes, you have to push the weight, you have to pull the weight, So they really drained you out muscle wise a lot, so your legs will hurt. This is more of an overall functional kind of fitness that I'm taking them through. Making them do 3 sets of jumping jacks. This is just for them to get back to their functional fitness, athletic abilities. We should all be able to do this. Shubham asked me for a home workout for someone who's not really trained in a while. Start with this, see how you feel. Ideally, I feel a person should be able to do 200 to 50 of them in a go. I also feel a person should be able to do 50 burpees in a go. But these are all subjective things according to your level of fitness. This is a good starting point, going through all the way up. Okay, clap your hands at the top. Yeah. More power. What are you on?
35.
This might be your starting point. Harshit might be a starting point. Puri might be a starting point. I could be a starting point. Someone who needs to gain weight, gain muscle could be a starting point. And everyone has to be tackled very differently. If someone who's been training with me or trained like me for 10 years or 12 years or 15 years, I would not obviously take them through this. But for someone, if you can correlate, you can relate to a Harshit or a Purvi, and you think someone at home can, your brother, your siblings, your aunt, your neighbors, anything, they should really start working out, tell them to check out this video and tell them to start. You have one more set of 50 jumping jacks. Let's go. Their heart rate is still up. I'm not letting them warm down completely. I feel when you warm down too much and you're not doing heavy sets and you're not pushing a lot of weight, you just lose that flow and then you don't feel like starting again. So their heart rate has come back sort of. You can see both of them are breathing slightly heavily and the third set starts. Okay, let's go. Now you can pace it up. Harshit, go faster. Nice. Now I will put a video of the first set of what they were doing and the third set. See how much more fluid they are. They're doing it together, they're in sync right now, they're not stopping, they're motivated, and this is a great thing that exercise does for your mental health. You know, it seems very, it feels like a lot of effort, but when you start working out, what it does for you mentally is great. Like you trained yesterday. How did you feel after the workout?
Very good.
You feel better, you're in a little bit of pain, you'll recover out of it, you sleep better, you eat better, your mental state of mind is amazing. So this is a benefit of training. For me, it's been weight training that has been neglected by a lot of people. You don't realize how much it does for your brain. You don't realize what this endorphin release actually means till you go through it. And there are going to be days where you're going to be like, oh shit, I have to do 30 minutes on the treadmill. But only when you've done years of 30 minutes on the treadmill, or years of 30 minutes on the Stairmaster, or years of 30 minutes of weightlifting, or 1 hour of weightlifting, you know if you can push through it, what it gives you at the end is way beyond anything that you can possibly get out of anything else. The endorphin release is very, very important. So Purvi is going to pull a chair and she's going to squat onto a chair. Yeah. Hydrate, guys. Whenever you're working out, please make sure you hydrate. So if you haven't already seen the push, the squat video, which is already on the YouTube channel, we are now squatting. Harshit is going to do regular squats, Purvi is going to squat in the chair. So go for 10 squats. The only thing these guys are thinking while doing the squat is that imagine their body has to move in a straight line. One, two, three,
yeah,
four. Sit down. Sit down. Sit on the chair. Yeah, up. Let's go. Harshit is doing 15, Purvi is doing 15. That's one set. You can do 3 to 5 sets like this and increase the number of sets in number of reps each workout. So he did 15 just now. His next workout might be 20. Yeah, walk around. Let the blood flow up. This is not a circuit. I'm not making them do a circuit. I'm just taking them through basic exercises that I feel everyone should be incorporating in their life. Nice. See, Purvi is going, her range of motion has improved. She's going all the way down on her own. Lower, Purvi, yes. Harshit, stop at 15, huh?
Oh.
Okay, relax. For the next set, you're going to grab a 5 kg.
50.
Nice. Look at Harshit's form. He's going to be a good squatter. I can already make it out. Purvi, keep your chest out. Keep your chest tight. Go lower. Sit down. Yes. Nice. Lower. Go lower. Yes. Purvi, full range of motion. Nice. This is the last working set for the squats. I'm not pushing them too much. I would love to push Harshit a little bit more, but I'm taking them through an entire sort of routine for today, so it's smooth and easy for them.
Guys, I've realized something which I was always confused about. So is there a right way or a right routine to follow, a right thing to do or not? So from what I understand, and correct me if I'm wrong, the best thing to do is actually work on each and every muscle of your body.
Right.
There's no routine, there is no plan that you need to follow as such.
You just have
but
to start.
If you start somewhere, you'll know you'll do a workout today, your legs are going to pain tomorrow. When they pain tomorrow, try and do the upper body, because that's the part that is not used.
Logic.
When you train that the next day, the day after that your legs are better, so you can start working. So alternate days, 2 days gap, 3 days gap, but work out some muscle part of the body every day.
Just move,
is what I think.
Is what I say. So the basic way is also, there'll be some days where you can't train at all, which is okay. But even then I would, you know, like even right now at home, what both of them have started doing is amazing. So we have a table outside, I'm going to show the footage later. We stand and work now. You know, we don't sit down as much. We move around a lot more. Because we are all at home in this such a heavy setup, we've changed the entire setup 3-4 times. So even that counts as exercise. Just moving a little bit more is very important for you.
Harshit, take the 10 kg plate.
Purvi, start squatting. Just moving a little bit more is very, very important. There is no right way, there is no wrong way to fitness. It's a very...
Let's go, start.
It's a very, very subjective thing, fitness, you know. Like yoga is fitness, powerlifting is fitness, MMA is fitness. And I remember at one point in my life, yeah, hold it up higher, like that. Yeah, around your chest. Okay, Purvi, sit down, pull all the way down. Yes, chest out, keep your chest out all the way down. Yeah, okay, Purvi, you can go 15 like this. Harshit, you just have 10. Smooth, keep your chest up. Nice. Think about fitness, I was talking to you guys about how subjective it is. I was, there was this point where I got very obsessed with lifting a car, and I got up my deadlifts and I lifted a car eventually. And one of my friends, really, really close friends of mine, Monish, he asked me that, buddy, what are you going to do with lifting so much weight? Are you going to lift a car in the middle of the road? And Monish at that point was really into yoga. And I'm like, buddy, what are you going to do by doing Tadasana? Will you do Tadasana in the middle of the road to stop traffic? See, what you guys need to understand is fitness is very subjective, and you need to do something that makes you feel good. It can be being more mobile, it can be more flexible, it can be just a handstand. It can be a push-up, it can be powerlifting. Do what makes you happy and enjoy the process. Don't get so caught up with, oh, this is right, this is wrong, this is the best. An MMA fighter told me what's the use of all the muscle. And he was having an argument in the gym that your muscle is useless, I'll punch you one, it's over. But we're not savages. This is not what this world has come up to. You enjoy boxing as a sport? Great. Go ahead and do it. So I'm taking them, I've taken them through a little bit of overall mobility, agility, heart rate being up. They've done an odd 3 to 5 sets of squats. Now they're going to do an odd 3 to 5 sets of lunges. This is their starting point. I won't push them too much after this. And they'll be moving a lot around the day. They'll be doing some flexibility work in the evening with me. So as of now, Kulbi has never lunged with me. Harshit has tried doing a lunge with me and he struggled a lot with it. So Harshit, just show me how you're going to lunge. One leg in front, one leg behind. I'm not going to get very technical into it regarding what muscle group is getting affected how, because those videos are already there on the channel. You know, different angles, different placement, different foot placement is going to be everything. On average, just stand, one foot back, put your weight in front, just push up and down. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Chest out. Okay. So he's going to go slightly wider because, yeah, nice. Nice. Pull you all the way down. All the way down. I thought Puri would need the chair, but she's learning faster than what I expected her to. Okay, so Puri, you're going to come here and you're going to face that side. Both of you are going to face that side. Harshit, a little behind, yeah. Start lunging, other leg. More range of motion. A little bit more range of motion. Smooth. So today we are doing more of a lower body weight split. I'm going to take them through a few more sets. Tomorrow I'm going to make them do a little bit more of upper body split. So ideally, lunging is also great for your core engagement. Obviously squats are, but I feel the way your core gets engaged when you squat to powerlift, that means you're bracing yourself, is very different. With a lunge, because you have to balance yourself at all times, even someone who doesn't know how to brace or hold their core tight, eventually does that. You'll notice it with time, the advanced lifters, people who've been training for a while know what I'm talking about. There's just a balance factor involved in it. Your body is just tighter. When you're squatting initially and you've never squatted, you don't really think about engaging your core. Only people who are professionally lifting are doing that. Let's go for the next set. Come on, guys.
Now which leg?
You have to do one leg, then the other, back to back. 10 reps.
The other leg?
Yeah. Sideways.
Transition.
Come on. One. Yes. Good. Two. Stand up full. Harshit. Pura upar ja. Yeah. Two more. Change your direction. Look the other way. Look the other way. Puri needs to go lower. Keep your chest out more. Keep your body more straight. Puri, look up more. Chest out more. Body more straight. Puri, listen to me. Body more straight. Yes.
No.
This doesn't count.
Okay.
Okay. So, for all of you who find it hard to do a lunge, and I think Tanya said that she wants to start working out, you can try this. You can balance off a chair or balance off something, and you can give it more range of motion. That takes a lot of your core out of the picture. It makes it smoother for you. It's just a mental assurance. Eventually, you want to lunge without anything. Eventually, you want to lunge with weights on you. But let's start with this. So, Harshit, Puri, breathe. Harshit, one hand on this. Now you want to lunge again. It's just going to get easier for him. Okay, chest out. This is just a support. We're not using it. See?
Oh. I know what I mean.
You can balance it. So what you can do also with your squats is, Purvi, come here. This is a supported squat. She's going to squat. No, you're going to hold this. Move your hands and you're going to squat. All the way down. Squat, squat, squat. This is not a lunge. Squat. Sit. Come in front. Come. Squat. Nice. Pull down. This is a good way to start. If you guys don't know where to start squatting and you want to really push yourself for reps, this is what you should do. Okay, Harshit, come back. Lunge. Yeah. All the way down. One. Two. Three. Stand up. Keep your hand. Use your weight now. Balance it off my body. Good up. One. Yes.
5, slow, 4. 5. Come on, keep going. 5 more. 4. 3. 2. 1. Now they are working partners, so they're going to help each other. If you guys, if your mom and dad want to start doing this, get them to start. Hi, auntie. Hi, uncle. Let's go. Come on. One more set, buddy. You're done. 5. 4 to 5 sets of squats, 4 to 5 sets of lunges. Some warm-ups before, some warm-ups after. Some stretching after.
So this is going to make me quit.
Let's go.
And it's going to kill me tomorrow.
Lunch.
Don't let that happen to you guys.
Use my hands. Lunge. One leg in front, one behind. Now go full all the way down. Use your body weight. You can use my hands to support yourself as much as you can. One. Full. Slow. Take your butt lower. Nice. One. Full low. Touching into the ground. Okay. Now almost touching to the ground. Yeah. Other leg. Stand up, look at me, go down. Stand up, wait, relax, go down. Relax. Two more. So I'm going to let them breathe a little bit, and then they're going to make each other do one set each. You don't need a tarang, you don't need me, you don't need anything. You just need to start. Very simple. You know, even just walking up and down for a lot of you is going to be exercise. Crawling up and down for a lot of you is going to be exercise. And it's great for your core. Walking on your hands is more advanced exercise. Guys, Purvi, you have to take Harshit through one set, you have to help him. And then Harshit, you have to take Purvi through one set. And then you guys are going to stretch. Last set. No waiting. No, it's Harshit's set.
So big to escape.
Sure, man.
Let's go. Come, what have you done? Let's go. Down. Breathe out while coming up. I'll count. Breathe out while coming up. Amateur advice, whenever you do something, you work out or whatever, make sure you stretch. Do not take it lightly. Do not think it's of no use. Stretch, cool down. Stretching and cooling down is the only thing that's going to wake you up tomorrow. Otherwise, forget it.
Otherwise, the pain is going to kill you.
Yes.
While they're stretching, I'm preparing for my workout. I am going to be doing my sets on the right side.
If you what's that in your hand, bro?
That's my pre-workout, bro. I'ma kill it.
I'm killing.
So for my pre-workout, I have some coffee and I have some my protein pre-workout as well. So this has some electrol, weirdly enough, because I feel a little bit dehydrated. I boxed for a bit last night.
It has my pre-workout and it has some impact EAs, all of which you can get on the MyProtein website. Use my code BrownBoy. Yes! And BrownBoy's gonna get in right about 5. So I'm gonna talk to you guys about supplements and who needs supplements, when Purveen Archer need supplements. Hell yes, they do. If they're not getting in enough protein, they do need a protein powder. And is it required? If you're not getting it from food, you probably should be getting in some protein. And it's a very neglected topic. I'm going to talk about it in the next video as well.
Guys, bye for tonight, today.
Both of you come and say bye. Do a nice ending clip. Subscribe to the channel. Comment, share, like. If you guys want to learn something from us, give an intro. And
there, you heard all of that, right?
Yeah. Go. Sit, both of you. Last part of the workout. Give your input on the workout. How you guys actually felt. Pull a chair now, bro, Ashit.
Go for it.
So guys, whatever it is, just start. Do something. I know this may seem a little bit too much, but trust me, it's not. It's the same thing, but you have to start somewhere. So just start. Follow Tarang. BrownBoy Aesthetics.
She doesn't even know what my page is called. She's living here with me.
I'm living beyond with you. That's why I'm calling you Tarang. I will not call you BrownBoy Aesthetics, right?
So, check out the page. On Instagram, it's BrownBoy Aesthetics. On YouTube, it's BrownBoy Aesthetics. The channel, comment, share, subscribe. Tell your friends about it. Interact with us. Tell us what you want us to make for you. Now, it's not only about bodybuilding. It's not only about fitness. It's about health and lifestyle. And we are here to help you. I've got Purvi here. I've got Harshit here. I'm taking them through some
guys,
basic workouts.
Do not forget to do jhadu, pocha, bartan, kapda in your house at this time. It's the best workout,
yes,
or the best post workout once you're done with this shit.
Pre and post.
Pre.
Alright, guys.
Keep your house clean, be safe.
It's time for my sets. I'm gonna see you guys very soon. Until the next video.
Bye.